So you're scared of heights. Is that to get you away from the Superman character? Is that why they tossed that in for the elevator scene or what?
No, that was always in the script way before they cast me. That was always just part of the program. But I think that gag, it just is a coincidence that there's a payoff because I'm known for Superman.
Did you think Superman held you back as being taken seriously as an actor? Because they go, well, he's Superman.
It didn't hold me back at all, because I've always thought I was terrific.
But yeah. No, I mean, getting parts, you know.
May have held other people back.
Yeah, in getting parts, it didn't...
Well, you never know what you don't get. Uh-huh. You know, like you're carefully protected from that information. I mean, I don't know what parts I haven't gotten, because I'm very grateful that I've gotten a lot of wonderful parts and will continue to do so. Because, I mean, the true story is that I'd been an actor since I was 15 years old, and I went to the same drama schools and with the same teachers as all the people like, you know, Bill Hurt and Kevin Klein and Mandy Patinkin and David Stiers, and we all hung out with the same teachers and did the same work. I just happened to do this weird departure, which is to play Superman, and now I've come back to the quote legitimate work. So I obviously see myself very differently than maybe the media does or the public at large.
You know, you're a workaholic. You're playing a good guy 24 hours a day.
Are we going to see Superman anymore, or are you going to?
You may, but I don't know.
Let him go back to Krypton, or
I don't know who'll be. I don't know who'll be playing the part.
Oh, really?
I mean, you may see Superman, but I don't know whether it would be with me or not. I mean, I hear talked about they're going to make a Superman 5, but no one's mentioned it to me or to the people that I work with.
No truth to the rumor that Don Knotts may get the role.
what a breakthrough! No, I think if they're going to do another Superman movie, it just really, a lot of effort has got to be made to put the quality back on the screen. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure, I mean, the kind of money that was spent to make the quality of Superman 1 back in 1977, those dollars don't go far enough in 1987 or 88 to bring the quality. And, mm-hmm. and I mean, that's really the problem, that the audience does smell it like that. If you haven't mm-hmm. really put something great up on the screen, it's just not going to go.
What's your next project?
Well, no, the next thing I'm going to do is right after I finish Summer in Smoke, which is mid-April, I'm going to go do a four-hour miniseries for NBC, which is your network, and I'm going to do a continuation of the story of The Great Escape. It picks up where the movie left off.
Oh, yeah, right.
And tells the true story of the successful efforts to bring some of those Gestapo officers who ordered the executions to justice.